Consortium to give us her welcome remarks. Don't they honorable Elizabeth Cloth, please?
Christopher Chow, honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. It gives me great pleasure to extend to you all a very warm welcome to the Smart Banking Wake Forward Luncheon of Smart City Consortium, SCC. To those who are not familiar with us, the Smart City Consortium was founded in March 2016. It aims to support the government in developing Hong Kong as the leading smart city in the region, through collaborations and sharing of different expertise. We have organized and support over 250 local and international events encompassing over 20,000 participants. With the continuous efforts of our partners, our key members, and our friends, SCC has signed 27 MOUs with 13 countries and regions, establishing a platform for collaborations and idea exchange with regards to the smart city visions. SCC has engaged professionals from all walks of life to provide suggestions to the governments. We also maintain a constant and effective dialogue with the government. Looking back at the humble beginnings just 2 years ago, I'm truly grateful to see how our key council members grew into this influential organization, with over 300 corporate and individual members, all passionate, all eager to help and to support. Smart banking is indeed an important topic, not only in the development of our financial sector, but also in the smart city development itself in Hong Kong. I would like to give a very special thanks to the Hong Kong MA and Norman for supporting this event. The initiative ranging from utilizing faster payment system to upgrading the supervisory sandbox to support open API and encouraging more synergy with FinTech are exciting and forward-looking. Today, we will discuss the topic of smart banking in the grand scheme of the smart city development, including implementations, alignment with the open API initiative, eKYC, and technical related legal issues. SCC values the opportunities to have established an open dialogue with the government at various levels to discuss the latest fintech topics such as blockchain and store value facilities, as we have licenses, is responding to the public consultation in trade single window by the Commercial and Economic Development Bureau. In the area of smart banking, specifically, we have been actively participated in promoting remote onboarding, non-face-to-face account opening for a secure assurance of clients' identity. This is done through local and overseas exhibitions and seminars. Last year, SCC has also written a proposal to government as a response to Hong Kong e-expert board. Our investment committee has also been facilitating investors and smart cities projects for different cooperation, including impact investment. Earlier in March this year, our FinTech committee has also submitted a consultation paper on open API framework for Hong Kong banking sector to Hong Kong MA. And recently, a fast payment system implementation sharing section with 13 store value facilities was also held. The smart city vision is of utmost importance to Hong Kong's future. A successful financial system is the key to strong economic development and long-term growth. And smart banking, with its extended development in EIB, big data, and open APIs, etc., is of the highest significance to a smart city's success. We are at an opportune time to be ahead, but we must do this together. Honorable guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to once again welcome you to our luncheon. A special thanks also goes to all the sponsors and all the panelists of this event. Thank you. you for supporting SCC's vision of developing Hong Kong into a smart city. And I wish you all an enjoyable and fruitful afternoon. Thank you very much. Thank you. The electronic payment is